guys, it's Sandy. I just wanted to get on here today and talk about some practical things that you probably need to get and have in your house. So beyond food, these are other just common sense, practical things that everybody should have. So the thing is, in 2019, everything seemed normal. I didn't even think about this stuff. Now, granted, I know electric goes out, natural disasters happen. You have to have some stuff in your house. I know that. But now I think of things differently, completely. The words like cyber attack and electric grid down and that kind of stuff, they weren't even in my vocabulary. I didn't even have to think about that kind of stuff. But then 2020 happened. And now we're in 2021 and things aren't getting back to normal. They're still really weird in the world. There's a lot of weird stuff going on. The natural disasters are unbelievable. The amount of droughts and wildfires and floods and everything that is happening, earthquakes, it's just everywhere. None of us are exempt from a natural disaster happening. You people that have gone through hurricanes, you know what it's like to live without electric. Well, I just want to share some basic things. Just think, what if we did lose electric power? How would that affect us? What if a cyber attack happened and it affected the gas stations, gas pumps don't work, or food, you can't go to the grocery store, or the banks are down? You know, just what would you need to do to make sure that you're in good shape at your house? So let me just show you some things that I've gotten. So let's start first with light, because light is very important. Dark can be really dark. So I bought these off of Amazon. I have a smaller one and a big one. This one came and I didn't realize how large it was whenever I had purchased it. And then it came and I was like, oh, that's big. But I decided to keep it because after reading about it, it'll put off a lot of light for a long time. So, and like I said, dark is really dark, you know, so I wanted just to have something that we had a good amount of light. I do have a battery lantern also that I like, but which is safer, you know, if you're going to bed or traveling or walking around with it. But these have been used for centuries and they really work, and it's a great source of safe light right here. But along with these, you can't just buy these and expect everything to work. Along with this, I have this funnel that I just keep with them, so whenever I need it, because you have to get the fuel down in here. So I just have a funnel, makes it easy, so I don't have to worry about spills. I got that at Walmart, so I just leave it with it. What is really important that you have to get though are the wicks to go with them. So they come with these wicks down in here. The wicks are about that long and that's it. So once those are gone, you don't have anything else, you know, this little wick. So when you buy these, you have to be aware that you have to buy the wicks also. So I bought these all off of Amazon. I'll link it below where I bought the best deals that I found. But you have to buy the right size wicks for the size lantern that you buy. So I have these cotton wicks. I think they come in like 6 foot rolls or something like that. I'm not sure what it is, but I think it's a 6 foot roll. That'll last for quite a while. So I keep these right in here. And then the other thing that you have to have is some kind of fuel for your lantern. You can buy a lamp oil, or you can buy, this one I have been told is a really good fuel because it doesn't have the fumes and the smell. I haven't used it yet, but the clean heat, so that's what I bought. And I also have some lamp oil also that I bought at Walmart. So these are my thoughts on light. You have to have a source of light. You just have to. So think about that, because any natural disaster could hit any of us at any time. None of us are exempt at all from something happening. So what if the electric goes out, you're hot, you need to go outside, get some bug spray. Put some bug spray in your house, get quite a few bottles of them. That way you just have it, because it would be miserable if you're hot and you're outside and you're getting bit by bugs swarming around you. So get some bug spray. It's so cheap, but it can make a big difference as far as, you know, comfort that you need. So get some of that. Now, this is a basic. You need food. I've talked about it. Other people have talked about it. Inflation is happening. Food prices are going up. The supply chain is changing. And more than that, the global food chain is what's really changing, because when there are all of these floods and droughts and freezes and the different things that's going on in different parts of the world, that does affect the food supply globally. So canned food is your best bet, because if you have a bunch of stuff in the freezer and the electric goes out and your generator only works for a little while, or you don't have a generator, or it's gas powered and you run out of gas, well, that won't last for super long. You know, so make sure that you have sustainable food too. Soup is real hearty, so that's a good thing to have. Get some fruit, get vegetables, canned tuna, canned fish, that is tuna, canned chicken, all that kind of stuff. Just get some stuff in your house. Basics, flour, sugar, rice, everything like that. So we know food. We understand the food part. Very, very important though. We can live without food for a while, but we cannot live without clean water. So get some water. I just picked up at Walmart. I have quite a few of them, because we have the clean water for one thing, but then we also have a way of getting more water if we need to. If you would need to at a creek or anything, then you have, you know, the gallon container that you can get more water to. Get some clean water, water bottles, whatever it is, put it into your house. And another thought that I went ahead and did are these life straws. I got like a pack of four off of Amazon. You can also find these in a camping section, because campers take these with them whenever they're hiking so that they can, you know, have clean water, make sure that they're getting clean water. People use them for different things. This is a life straw. So you gotta have a source of getting clean water. It's so very, very important to have that. Another thing that I wanna show you is for cleanliness. You gotta be able to sanitize, because sickness could go real, real fast if you do not have clean spaces that you're in, or you're not able to sanitize things. So get yourself, make sure you have plenty of soap in your house, and bleach, white vinegar, whatever it is, get some and have it in your house. Like I said before, you guys, this is just common sense stuff that most of you probably have, but get a little extra, because this is what you need to be comfortable in your home and to keep your family healthy. So get some bleach. I got super sick a couple weeks ago with a stomach virus that I caught. I hadn't been sick in years, and it wiped me out for quite a few days. And I actually thought about it then. Sanitation is so important, because you could get sick, or somebody in your house gets sick, and you gotta be able to clean. So make sure and have bleach, soap, whatever it is. Buy extras, have it in your house now. I've said this so many times. If you're prepared, then you're not scared. And if you have it and don't need it, you're out nothing. But if you need it and don't have it, life, it could be really, really hard. So get these basic things. Another thing that you really, really need to think about is how you can cook without electric. So this is a gas stove. This is a gas one stove. I got it off of Amazon. I have a video that I will link in the description below and try to put it somewhere up there also on exactly how to use it. You guys, it's like under $30. It was like $20 when I did the first video. It's gone up. I don't know exactly what it is now, maybe 25. I don't know if it's 30. I'm not sure what it is now, but this is a lifesaver right here. You need a butane gas. You can't just buy the stove. You gotta have the gas to also use, you know, fuel it. But cheap, as far as the easiest thing you can cook on. Look, this is how small it is. Watch my video on how to use it. This is a lifesaver for under $30, you guys. It will make life so much better for you if you need to cook on. If you don't have electric, you can't cook. And then the last thing that you really need to think about and have in your house is medicine. Make sure and have an ability to be able to do first aid at home. So this one, I just have bandages in, an antibiotic ointment, and I've got all kinds of cold, flu, Tylenol, that kind of stuff, and another one. One thing that I realized that I don't have, I got some poison ivy when I was out pulling weeds, and I just had a little tiny bit of hydrocortisone left. I need to get more hydrocortisone and Benadryl to have in the house too, because again, those are things that can make comfort so much better, because you get into something that's poison or steaming nettles or anything like that, you'd be very, very uncomfortable without having the right meds. So just have your medicine stocked, and that way you don't have to worry about it. So I'm gonna go and get some Benadryl and some more hydrocortisone. As far as Benadryl, that could be life-saving also. Make sure and have some at your house, because if somebody has a terrible allergic reaction, the Benadryl is there to help. So, you know, just have it. I have said this, you guys, it's common sense, right? But it also just helps to have some ideas of what somebody else is doing also. If we had a cyber attack, or if our electric goes down, or if a natural disaster hits you really hard, or if you have a job loss, or inflation starts really raising prices, get the stuff now. You're prepared, you've got everything taken care of, and you don't have to worry. Again, this is not fear-mongering, you guys. I am not trying to make anybody afraid. I'm just trying to make people aware of some things that they could be doing. So again, I'm just sharing my heart with you, and you can agree with it or not, and you can do with whatever you want to do with this. You know, you can prepare or not, but I just wanted to help others. Okay, until next time, I'm out.